Right now, the shaky rollout and low enrollment numbers for the Affordable Care Act are now causing some of President Obama's Democratic supporters to reevaluate. Our national correspondent, Christine Prezao, has new evidence that shows the foundation is not as strong as it once was.
As the temperatures in Washington hover near freezing, it seems ties between the president and his allies are cooling as well. With 39 or one-fifth of House Democrats this month voting in favor of a Republican bill that could threaten the viability of the health care law. Among those Democrats, Oregon's Kurt Schrader.
I think our leadership and the president missed a great opportunity to join hands with Republicans and say, okay, Fred, this is something we could almost agree with you on. Let's modify this a little bit and let's work together.
Working together has been a rarity on Capitol Hill, but for Democrats facing tough re-election battles, they had no choice but to distance themselves from Obamacare.
This has been a topic of concern and conversation. So I wanted to vote yes to let my constituents know that I heard what they had to say.
Historian Alan Lichtman says it's still too early to determine the best strategy for those in tight races.
The loser in this hotly partisan battle is going to be whoever makes the last mistake.
Those approval ratings have been the lowest ever for President Obama, including a new poll showing less than half of those surveyed believe he is honest and trustworthy.
With lawmakers back in their district for the holiday, it's hard to tell if these fractures within the Democratic Party will deepen or be repaired. Now, higher health care enrollment numbers and a better functioning website would help, but experts say when it comes to elections, the art of association is hard to escape.
You can't run away from the president of your own party. You can try, but it doesn't work. The problems with the Affordable Care Act and with the president's approval rating affects Democrats across the board.
But many Democrats will still try to make the case that you can make your own decisions in Washington.
There's no one big monolithic Democratic Party that I know of. And the good news is we're not eating our own, like or the other team, if you will.
In Washington, I'm Christine Prezao reporting.
Well, the White House confirms that things are now moving along according to plans. It says the website will be available by the end of the month for most of the public.